I think some of us here are curious to know more about how you position yourself in light of not characterizing yourself in the humanist tradition, how you see yourself in light of the more recent popularity of post-humanist theory, new materialisms, object-oriented ontology.
This is a nice problem because I'm, of course, although I appreciate some of them, they're not stupid, by far not, but I think that precisely, and that's my big, I had a couple of debates with the new star of disorientation, Graham Harman, and so on. Mm-hmm. They are, for me, way too, in some sense, even if they are against this centered on subjectivity, humanism. But nonetheless, I think this dimension that I was talking about, the dimension of this radical negativity, zero, potential destruction, death drive, disappears there. Their mm-hmm. world is the world of objects. Mm-hmm. So my, when I had the debate with Graham Harman, and he claims subject is just one among objects, maybe more powerful, but nonetheless, and so on. I claim, no, subject is not this. And it's not that I think subject is an all-powerful entity, mega object. No, subject is some almost nothing, a vanishing entity, pure appearance, and so on. But it's not, subject is not an object like others. And this is why also the Freudian unconscious is not an objective determination of my being. So, but I've written a lot about it, this settling the accounts with this new object-oriented ontology and so on. You know, because, sorry, just this, because I think that I'm here, I agree with them, with object-oriented ontologists, that we should somehow get over the standard Kantian transcendental horizon. But for me, what they do is simply a massive return to old realist ontology. Mm-hmm. And for me, this is way too arrogant. I'm not ready to do that step.